Good morning, fellow mathematicians. A lot of people requested that I should make some videos in English. So let's go ahead and get started. You might agree with me that we could add a zero in the denominator right here and it wouldn't change anything. And if you're a smart boy, you might notice what a zero actually is. So we can rewrite this as the integral going from 0 to infinity of dx over x to the 4th power plus 2x squared cosine of 2a plus 1. And now you might ask yourself, how in the hell, Papa Flemmy, is this thing the same as that one? Well, for a value of a being pi over 4, this relationship holds because we are getting the cosine of pi over 2, and at 0, this is going to vanish, and bam, it holds. So this relationship holds for a value of a of pi over 4. And keep this in mind, it's going to be quite important in the end. And as always, we are going to call this infinity boy right here, I, capital I, for integral. And now I would like to introduce a substitution. We are going to call it 1 over t. So let x be equal to 1 over t. What does that also mean? That also means that dx is nothing but minus 1 over t squared dt. And now we can plug all the information into here. So that also means that I is nothing but the integral going from. We have new boundaries. Look at that right here. We can rewrite this as 1 over x being equal to t. If you plug a 0 into this x, we get 1 over 0. This approaches infinity in the limit. And also, if we let x approach infinity, that makes 1 over infinity, that's 0 in the limit. So those are our new boundaries. And now we can plug all the other information in. We know what the x is. That's minus 1 over t squared dt, and then over. Now plugging 1 over t into all the x's is 1 over t to the 4th power plus 2, 1 over t squared cosine of 2a plus 1. And now I would make use of the fact that we can distribute this minus into here to change the boundaries, going from 0 to infinity then. And also I would like to advance this fraction by a 1. But what is a 1? That's nothing but t to the 4th power over t to the 4th power. Let's plug everything in and see what we get. Now we have the integral going from 0 to infinity of, now we have t squared over, this is becoming t to the 4th power plus 2 t squared cosine of 2a plus 1 dt. That's a mouthful once again. I'm already out of breath. And I want you guys to remember that substitution is an equivalent process. That means this thing right here is still I. And I is not with respect to t. That means it doesn't matter if you call this variable an x, a plant, your mother, your stupid ass dog. It doesn't matter. So this expression right here is still the same as this right here. And this allows us to add them together. So what would happen if we add I and I together? Well, on the one hand, we are getting 2i. But what is 2i? Well, we have the same upper and lower bounds. So we have the integral going from 0 to infinity. We can add those two together because using the linearity of the integral. And also, we are getting the same denominator. We can use x once again. X to the 4th power plus 2x squared cosine of 2a plus 1. And also, what do we have in the numerator? Well, we have a t squared. It's now going to be an x squared and we have a 1. So in the numerator, we end up with 1 plus x squared dx. And that's great. Now I would like to get a final expression for I. That means we can multiply both sides by 1 half because not equal to 0. So that thing holds. And also I want you guys to remember a little property of odd and even integrands. I hope you guys remember that if some function f of x is even f of x, that means if we take the symmetric integral going from minus a to a over this integrand right here, over this function, we can rewrite this as follows. This is 2 times the integral going from 0 to a of f of x dx. I hope you remember this little property. What does even actually mean? If we plug a minus x into this f of x, we end up with the f of x itself. And what we can do, we can multiply both sides by 1 half, and we end up with this identity right here. And that's exactly what we can use. If we plug a minus x into here, all the powers of x are even. That means we end up with the integrand itself. That makes it an even integrand, and we are going to make a symmetric integral out of that. So that means we now have a lower bound going from minus infinity to infinity, and also we have to multiply by 1/2 by this identity here. So we end up with a constant of 1 over 4 in front. And now we are going to make something out of this ugly looking denominator. So the next step in the solution of this integral, using Papa's way, is as counterintuitive as everything else that you have seen before right here. So let's just dive right in. I hope you guys remember the double angle formula for the cosine. So that means cosine of 2a is nothing but cosine squared of a minus sine squared of a. But there's another identity. We know that cosine squared of a is nothing but 1 minus sine squared of a. We can plug this in. So this makes 1 minus 2 times sine squared of a. And we can make use of that. We can plug this into the denominator, and this fact makes it possible to factor the denominator a little bit. So let's take a look at the denominator. So x to the 4th power plus 2x squared, and now we are plugging the information of cosine of 2a in, so that makes 1 minus 2 sine squared of a plus 1. We can distribute this 2x squared into everything. I'm going to bring it into a new order, so that makes it more clear in the end. Now we have x to the 4th power plus. Now we have 2x squared plus 1. And we also have minus 4x squared sine squared of a. Minus 4x squared sine squared of a. This right here in front is just the binomial formula. So this makes x squared plus 1, but the whole thing squared. And also, this expression right here is nothing but 2 times x times the sine of a, but the whole thing squared. And we are taking the difference of two squares right here. And there's another formula for that. That means we can factor this denominator right here into. Now we have x squared minus 2x sine of a plus 1 times x squared plus 2x sine of a plus 1. This doesn't look any better than in the beginning. It just seems like we are making it worse. But now we can just use some sexy little symmetry tricks to make this into something really spicy. So now we can plug all the information into our integral. That also means that I is nothing but 1 over 4 times the integral going from minus infinity to infinity of 1 plus x squared over x squared minus 2x sine of a plus 1 times x squared plus 2x sine of a plus 1 dx. Whew, that's a mouthful, just like before, even more of a mouthful. And just like in the beginning, I hope you guys agree with me that we could add a zero to this whole thing and it wouldn't change anything. But what exactly is a zero? I want you guys to remember a different identity, just like with this one before. And this identity I have actually proven on my channel. So if f of x is odd. Odd function means that if we plug a minus x into here, we end up with minus f of x. Then a symmetric integral of this new f of x, which is an odd function, is just going to be zero. So that's a matter of fact, link in the description. And we are going to make use of that because we can get rid of one of those factors, and we want to get rid of this right here, just for factoring purposes in the end, by using this trick down here. So what is a zero exactly? Let's just put it here. That is 1 over 4 times the integral going from minus infinity to infinity of. And this denominator stays as it is. So that's the same thing. We want to add them together in the end. And also, in the numerator, we are going to have minus 2x sine of a dx. And indeed, if we plug minus x into here, then all the other powers down here were even. That means we end up with positive x down here, but right here we have x to the first power. So that means if we plug minus x into here, we are ending up with minus the integrand itself. So that's not integrand over a symmetric integral, it vanishes, it's zero. And that's absolutely nice, because we can add those together. They have the same numerator, and they have the same denominator, and we can bring the numerators together. So we have now 1 over 4 times the integral going from minus infinity to infinity of 1 minus 2x sine of a plus x squared over x squared minus 2x sine of a plus 1 times x squared plus 2x sine of a plus 1 dx. And in the words of Dr. Payam, bam and bam, this is going to cancel out, and we end up with this simplified integral, and we are going to work with it. Now we are almost done. Thank God. Only a few more steps to go. So this denominator right here looks nearly like something we could factor, because we have an x squared plus 2x sine of a. All that's missing for us to factor this right here is a sine squared of a, to use the binomial formula. Do we have a sine squared of a? Well, we do. By God! We have this 1 right here, but what is a 1? That's nothing but sine squared of a plus cosine squared of a. And that's nice, because this expression right here allows us to factor this right here. So now we have 1/4 times the integral going from minus infinity to infinity of dx over. This factored is nothing but x plus sine of a, but the whole thing squared, and also plus cosine squared of a. And solving this right here is really easy. I have derived this formula before, link in the description. It's going to give us an expression for the inverse tangent. But at first, I would like to introduce a new substitution. So let u be equal to x plus sine of a. If we differentiate that, that also means that du is nothing but dx. Sine of a is just a constant, so differentiating a constant gives us zero. We can plug this information in. What do we end up with now? I is nothing but 1 over 4 times the integral going from. If we plug minus infinity into here, sine of a, and we want a to be pi over 4 in the end, it's just a positive value or something. It's finite at least. So our boundaries wouldn't change. Minus infinity to infinity. And now we have du over u squared plus cosine squared of a. Well, that's easy to solve. We have done this before. So that's 1 over 4 times the cosine of a, and also times the inverse tangent of u over cosine of a. Going from minus infinity to infinity. The value of a is going to be pi over 4 in the end. So this thing right here is strictly positive. So in the limit, as the inverse tangent, the argument of the inverse tangent approaches infinity or minus infinity, this cosine doesn't have an effect. So this right here is nothing but, so inverse tangent of infinity gives us pi over 2. So that's that right here. And then minus inverse tangent of minus infinity gives us minus pi over 2. So in the end, this right here is going to be just pi. Now we end up with pi over 4 times the cosine of a. But just like I said, we are not completely done yet. That's supposed to be a 4 right here. Because this right here is just the answer to this integral. But we want the answer for this right here. So let's plug in pi over 4 and see what we get. You can calculate the value of cosine of pi over 4 in your head, by hand, or put it into your calculator. I'm going to give you a little hint. I is now pi over 4 times 1 over square root of 2. So that's the value of cosine of pi over 4. It's 1 over square root of 2. Now take the reciprocal of this. We end up with square root of 2 times pi over 4. And then we are done. Whoop whoop! That's the sound the police makes. That right here is the answer, and I hope you did enjoy this little excourse into the world of sexy integrals without partial fraction decomposition. I hope you did enjoy this video, this little remake, even though it was a remake. If you did enjoy, please like and subscribe and recommend me if you like. Please activate the bell thingy so that you get all the notifications from my channel. If you want to support me a bit more, that means if you want me to get some more equipment or stuff like this, then take a look into the description. There will be a link to my Patreon. I would appreciate all kinds of support from you guys. And up until the next video, have phlegm the day. See ya.
Schaff ich.
Ja, locker.
Hallo. Was ist, wenn ich von hier in das Netz da drüben treffe?
Dann hättest du das komplette Spiel gewonnen.
Boah, jetzt müsste ich eigentlich gut stabilisieren, oder?
Soll ich das mal probieren?
Ja.